The knife has to be one of the most fun weapons to use in this game, but it doesn't mean it's easy to complete. So if you're looking for specific tips, timestamps will be linked in the description below. At the time I'm making this, the knife is the only melee weapon in the game that is required for Dark Matter, and I think it's gonna stay that way. The sledgehammer and the sword are being added soon, but they're not required. Since it's the only weapon of this class that needs to be completed, let's quickly clear up a common misconception. The knife is technically a special weapon, so in order to get a diamond, you need to complete both the knife and the M79. Now that that's out of the way, let's get into the camos. For the spray camo, you need to kill 75 enemies in multiplayer. Honestly, 75 isn't too bad. You just have to get in the groove of using the knife effectively. And to do that, you need to build your class around the knife. Here's the class that I use during my knife grind. The primary can be whatever you want, but you won't be using it much, if at all, if you're solely focusing on the knife. For the wild card, I use Danger Close. This gives you 2 tacticals and 2 lethals, which can help a lot when you're using this weapon that has 0 range. The tactical I recommend is the smoke grenade. With the smoke grenade, you eliminate the range aspect of using the knife, creating a nice, safe area to pass through or even sit in to get kills. I often use this tactic to get across parts of the map without being seen. I use smokes over flashes and stuns because they last way longer and you can't blind or slow yourself down with one if you accidentally fuck up a throw. And let's be honest, we all do every now and again. For the lethal, I recommend using the tomahawk. Not only is it sick and it fits with the theme of using the knife, but it's the fastest range option you can have in the lethal slot. This can save you if an opponent catches you running at them or you get caught out in the open. For the field upgrade, the jammer is your best bet. Putting your jammer in spots you're commonly at, eliminate another way for an opponent to spot you. For the first perk slot, I use forward intel. To be honest, I'm not too sure what it does, but from my understanding, it shows you on your minimap where people spawn, which is very helpful on Nuketown where spawns are constantly flipped. But if you're not on board with it, Flak Jacket is your best option for staying alive. For the second perk, I definitely go with Quartermaster. This will recharge your smokes and tomahawks every 25 seconds. The tracker perk is a close second. For the third perk, Ninja is the move. If they already can't see you in the smoke or on the minimap, the last thing you need to eliminate is their ability to hear you. You'll also catch so many people off guard with this perk. Once you have all that set up, this camo should get done quick. Also, the best mode for this by far is Nuketown 24/7. If that's not available, I actually had a lot of fun using it in Combined Arms Assault on Cartel. And just normal domination will work too. Difficulty? Effortless. For the Stripes camo, you need to get 25 Backstabber medals in multiplayer. This one can get a little tricky. Getting behind opponents can be made easier if you use the class tips from the previous camo section of this video. The hard part about this is not assassinating people. This is hard to avoid because it's a little too sensitive when it comes to determining whether or not an assassination should take place. The best way to avoid this is to quickly click or press your attack button instead of holding it down, as well as swinging your knife earlier than you normally would outside of the assassination range and then run at the opponent. Sliding can also help you avoid an assassination, but I'm not too sure, so take that with a grain of salt. This is a little RNG based, but 25 is not a lot, so you'll get there eventually. Difficulty? Frustrating. For the classic camo, you need to execute 25 finishing moves. This camo and the stripes camo go hand in hand. You'll usually end up doing the opposite of the one that you're trying to complete, but all you gotta do is get close behind a player and hold down your attack button to perform an execution. Once it's activated, you just gotta hope that some good Samaritan doesn't come around and try to stop you during the half hour it takes to complete them. Smokes helped a lot with this challenge and stopped me from getting cucked most of the time. Difficulty? Kinda sick though. For the geometric camo, you need to get 50 kills while injured in multiplayer. I feel like they run out of ideas so fast for these challenges. Anyways, getting kills while injured kinda just happens while you're using the knife. You're bound to get shot a few times while rushing someone down. If you're desperate for kills while injured, jumping out of the windows on Nuketown and taking fall damage works as well as barely running through an enemy's napalm strike. If you're down bad, you can hurt yourself with a Molotov, but I hope it doesn't have to come down to that. Difficulty? Cyberpunk on the PS4. For the Flora camo, you need to get 50 kills while sliding in multiplayer. This one's pretty self-explanatory. All you gotta do is sprint and then hit your crouch button to slide and then get a kill while you're doing it. This is most easily done if an opponent is facing away from you, obviously. Just get in the habit of running and sliding while using the knife and use it as movement practice and you'll get nutty at the game. Difficulty? Brainless. For the science camo, you need to kill 50 enemies disoriented by smoke, flash, or stun grenades in multiplayer. This is very straightforward. Like mentioned previously, smokes are the way to go. They last the longest out of the three and have the largest range and can affect multiple people after the initial throw. Toss the smokes at objectives, choke points, or in the houses to increase your chances of getting progress towards this camo. Difficulty? Easy Mac. For the psychedelic camo, you need to get 25 double kills. This is the hardest challenge for this weapon, but it can be done pretty easily. I know that's kind of contradictory, but if you go on a tear, you'll end up knocking a few out. But the most consistent way to get it done is to toss a smoke into a heavy traffic spot and sit in or around it. A lot of the time, people just push right through a smoke, either to get out of one of the houses on Nuketown or to get to an objective. Just stay patient and the kill should come right to you. Also, try to mix up your movement. Just slide around and move as unpredictably as possible to avoid getting killed before you can pick up a double. Just have some fun and mess around and this challenge should go by fast. Difficulty? Super Meat Boy. That's all the tips I have for getting the knife gold. If this helped you at all or you learned something new, drop a like on it. If not, dislike. If you're part of the 65% of people who watch my videos and aren't subscribed, help a dude out and hit that sub button. I also stream over on Twitch, so come stop by and see the grind live. All my links will be in the description below if you want to see some more content. And if you watch all the way to the end of the video, leave a salamander in the comments below because Sam said so. Also, leave your difficulty ratings there as well, and if I like them, I'll put them in the next video. Anyways, I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.